Regularly scheduled programs have been rescheduled or preempted tonight in order that we may bring you the following CTV special presentation. Live from Toronto, the 35th anniversary Miss Canada pageant 1982, featuring 36 regional representatives from across Canada. With your hosts, Jim Carrey and Barbara Kelly. Special guest stars, Brian Mackay and Judy Marshak. Special guest appearance, Jack Duffy. And the 1981 reigning Miss Canada, Dominique Dufour. The Miss Canada pageant is brought to you in part by Scott Paper's family of fine products and by your bottler of Coca-Cola, the champion of soft drinks. Ladies and gentlemen, your host for this evening, Jim Carrey.
Hello and welcome. It's nice to have you here. We all could use a little sun this time of year. I gotta say, I'm honored. Composure's come undone. 'Cause I've been told this pageant's 35 years young. You know we won't need much persuasion to bring the girls out to celebrate this grand occasion. Here they are before us, both audience and host, the pride and joy of Canada from coast to coast.
Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Joanne Chisson, 20 years of age, representing Red Deer, Alberta. Thanks go to CKRD Radio and Television.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Simone Frere. I'm 19 years of age, representing Brampton, Ontario. I'd like to thank my sponsors, the Brampton Pine Rose Festival and The Guardian.
Hi, I'm Jacqueline McLean, 19 years old, from Saskatoon, Saskatchewan. Many thanks to CFQC-TV and Market Mall.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Corinne Turner. I'm 18 years old from Oakville, Ontario. I'd like to thank my sponsors, the Oakville Beaver and Hopedale Mall.
Hi, I'm Julie Sam from Fort St. John, B.C. I'm 21 years old, and I'd like to thank my sponsor, the City of Fort St. John.
Bonsoir, mon nom est France Trudel. J'ai 22 ans, je viens de Trois-Rivières, Québec, et mon commanditaire est Chim Télé 8 et les fermes Compte Jean Coutu.
Brian Mackay has joined us tonight, so be aware. He's a singer and a dancer extraordinaire.
'Twas 1946, the year the pageant first begun. And these girls tonight weren't born then, not a single one. The world emerged from wartime into a brand new day. And a streetcar named Desire opened on Broadway. Back then in 47 nations conceived the UN to arbitrate their world relations. Remember Harry Truman, his Marshall Plan unfurls. And now please let us introduce our next six girls.
Bonsoir, mon nom est Sylvie Lavallée, j'ai 23 ans, from Laval, Quebec. My sponsor is Les Entreprises Girard Incorporé.
Good evening, my name is Joanne Prou, I'm 19, I represent my city, Montreal. I'd like to thank my sponsor, Les Communications de Fort Incorporé.
Bonsoir, hello, my name is Renee McLaughlin, I'm 20 years old, and I'm very happy to represent Hamilton, Ontario. My sponsors are HMS Promotions and Lime Ridge Mall.
Good evening, my name is Alana Patrak. I'm 21 years old from Kitchener-Waterloo. I'd like to thank my sponsor, KW Oktoberfest.
Good evening, my name is Lauren Williams. I'm 21 years old representing Calgary. I'd like to thank my sponsor, CFCN Radio and Television.
Good evening, bonsoir. My name is Debbie Will, 20 years of age. Many thanks to Bathurst Festival Commission, Bathurst, New Brunswick.
In 1957, the year of rock and roll, our fast maturing pageant had reached 10 years old. I'd like to introduce you to someone you'll adore, the lovely Judy Marshak, who could say much more.
John Glenn was in orbit in 1962, and Lawrence of Arabia had just come through. The Telstar satellite in space is the Cuban Missile Crisis had joined history's pages. The 15th year of pageant, and isn't it a sin? The Argos were still looking for their second wind.
Good evening, I'm Cindy Benson representing Edmonton, Alberta. I'm 23 years old, thanks to my sponsor, CFRN Television.
Good evening, I'm Julie McLeod, 22, from Mississauga. Thanks to my sponsor, the Mississauga News and Sheridan Mall Merchants Association.
Hello, I'm Yvonne Robinson representing Toronto. I'm 23 years old and my sponsors are the Metropolitan Toronto Police Amateur Athletic Association.
Hi, I'm Madeleine Kelly, 21 years old, representing friendly Fort McMurray, Alberta. Thanks to the Kinsmen Club of Fort McMurray.
Bonsoir, good evening. My name is Kiki Christian and I'm 19 years old. I'm very proud to represent Prince George, BC. I'd like to thank my sponsor, CKPG Radio and Television.
Hello, my name is Lori Meidinger. I'm 19 years old, representing the beautiful Interior British Columbia. My sponsor is the BC Interior Committee and Sunrite Group Products Limited.
In 1967, our hostess then was famed. She won the crown that year, and Barbara Kelly, she was named.
'67 and my joy was just unbound. Little Snoopy hit Broadway in You're a Good Man, Charlie Brown. We saw Guess Who's Coming to Dinner. We celebrated our centennial that year, a winner. You read Rosemary's Baby that year and died of fright. Here are six more girls to introduce themselves to you tonight.
Good evening, I'm Rosalie Wild, representing Grand Prairie, Alberta. I'm 21 years old, thanks to my sponsors, Grand Prairie Productions.
Bonsoir, good evening, my name is Caroline Van Egg, and I'm 18 years old. I'm very pleased to represent Ottawa Valley, thanks to my sponsors, CJOH Broadcasting Limited.
Hi, I'm Irene Slavikowski from Windsor, Ontario. I'm 23 years old, my sponsor is CKLW FM Radio.
Hi, I'm Nora Jennings, I'm 20 years old, and I'm proud to represent the city of Sault Ste. Marie, Ontario. My sponsors are the Pee Wee Arena Association and Coca-Cola.
Good evening, my name is Karen Bald, I'm representing London, Ontario. I'm 18 years old, and I'd like to thank my sponsors, CKSL Radio and Westmount Mall.
Hello, my name's Neva Prusolo. I'm 19 years old, and I represent the beautiful city of Vancouver. Many thanks to Metro Community Council.
With interest rates arising, the dollar's almost done. Wave fiscally farewell to 1981. Our reigning queen was almost Miss Universe, my friend. Her name is Dominique Dufour, and she's the end.
On this magnificent occasion, let joy be unconfined. Though taking part can warm your heart to win sublime. Being Miss Canada's a pleasure. Here's six more girls, each one of them a perfect treasure.
Bonsoir, je m'appelle Cynthia Francis. I'm representing Nova Scotia. I'm 21 years old, and I'd like to thank my sponsor, the Nova Scotia Provincial Exhibition.
Bonsoir, good evening. My name is Gail Craig. I'm 20 years old, and I'm proud to represent Burnaby, British Columbia. I'd like to thank my sponsors, the Wilson Cardero Associates.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Colleen Furlong, and I'm very proud to represent St. John, New Brunswick. I'm 18 years of age, and my sponsor is Lawless Days.
Good evening, bonsoir. My name is Linda Lillegault. I'm 19 years old, representing the South Shore of Quebec. My sponsors are La Production JCM.
Hello, everyone. I'm Brenda Gorlick, and I represent the province of Manitoba. I'm 23 years of age, and my sponsor is the Red River X Association.
Hi, I'm Terry Harmon. I'm 18 years old, and I'm proud to represent Prince Albert, Saskatchewan. My sponsors are the Prince Albert Winter Festival Committee.
Closing House of Polish is 1982. We hope that it's a wondrous year for you and you.
And this is what we hope your fates are, that all your salaries keep up with what our mortgage rates are.
Here's our last six ladies. Their time has finally come. They've played their parts, and in our hearts they're number one.
Good evening, my name is Kelly Morak. I'm 21 years old and very proud to be representing Yellowknife Northwest Territories. Special thanks to my sponsor, Mackenzie Media.
Hi, I'm 24-year-old Renata Kratz from Regina, Saskatchewan. Many thanks to the Regina Exhibition Association and CKCK Radio.
Good evening, my name is Krista Lee Golding. I'm 18 years old and very proud to represent Newfoundland and Labrador. Thanks to my sponsor, Trinity Conception Fair.
Hi, my name is Linda Marie Lank. I'm 22 years old and I'm proud to represent Prince Edward Island. Many thanks to the Summerside Lobster Carnival.
Bonsoir, je m'appelle Linda Fauchette, j'ai 21 ans. I represent Fort Frances, Ontario. My sponsors are the Fun in the Sun Committee and Retail Merchants.
Good evening, my name is Elizabeth Evans, 23, representing Niagara Falls, Ontario. Many thanks to Niagara Promotion Association.
And there you have it. It's plain for all to see. Our 35th year's pageant anniversary. And here's a thought I know will buoy us. That the next 35 of them are just as joyous.
Set off the fireworks and let them light. This ain't no night to spend the night. Put on your fancy dress this night of nights. You're coming with us while we hit the ice. Cause Miss Canada, Miss Canada,
Anniversary Miss Canada Pageant 1982 will return.
Cottonelle is as soft as cotton.
You can feel the cotton softness, the softness of cotton.
Once again, your host for the 35th Anniversary Miss Canada Pageant 1982, Jim Perry. Thank you. Thank you very much. And good evening. Welcome to this very special Miss Canada Pageant 1982. May I add that this year we have a total of 36 representatives vying for the title of Miss Canada, making this, our 35th anniversary pageant, the largest ever. The young ladies you are meeting tonight truly represent every part of Canada from coast to coast. And let me point out that they are all winners from their own particular region of the country. And one of these 36 lovely young ladies will be chosen for the coveted title Miss Canada 1982. And incidentally, you may have noticed Miss Burnaby Gail Craig limping a little bit. She had a small accident, but like a trooper, she's carrying on. Now, before I introduce our distinguished panel of judges, allow me to briefly explain the judging process. The areas of competition are evening wear, swimwear, poise, personality, and intellect. Last Friday night, the girls appeared before our judges in a preliminary show in front of an audience. At that time, each of our judges had an opportunity to observe all 36 representatives. And prior to that, the judges spent time with all the girls individually. And their final decisions, of course, will be made tonight. Believe me when I say that accepting this responsibility is a most difficult task indeed. And with that in mind, may I introduce our distinguished panel of judges. First, I'd like to welcome back for the 10th year the coordinator of the Fashion Technique and Design Department of Sheridan College, the chairperson of our panel of judges, Patricia Guire. From Los Angeles, the distinguished actor who has represented this country so splendidly all over the world, Mr. John Vernon. Fashion coordinator for Yorkdale Shopping Center in Toronto, Norma Wildgoose. From Ottawa, couturier and fashion designer of Maison de Haute Couture, Richard Robinson. And as one should say at this time, last but by no means least, principal dancer of the National Ballet of Canada, Karen Kane. The results of the judges' balloting will be tabulated by Terry Scandrett of Clarkson Gordon. At this time, I would like to introduce to you the president of Clio Productions, the company that owns, organizes, and manages the Miss Canada pageant and who make this pageant telecast possible, Mr. E.J. Delaney. May I also present the general manager of Clio Productions, Miss Elaine Annisman. On this, our very special 35th anniversary of the Miss Canada pageant, we've invited four former Miss Canadas from across the country to help celebrate this very happy occasion, and you'll be meeting them throughout the show. This is also an anniversary for me. It is my 15th year as host of the pageant, and I would like to welcome someone who, for the past 9 years, has shared this most exciting evening with me. A former Miss Canada herself, the always delightful Barbara Kelly.
And may I say that over the years, it's been more than a pleasure to participate in the pageant, especially tonight on this, our 35th anniversary. Now, I know you're all waiting eagerly for the outcome of this night of nights. And this very moment, I know the feeling that our 36 representatives are experiencing. A little jittery and apprehensive, to say the least. So let us begin with all 36 girls and a rare opportunity to model five of Canada's leading fashion designers' latest creations, which, by the way, was photographed at the most beautiful Scarborough Civic Center. Ladies and gentlemen, our 35th anniversary Miss Canada pageant designer collection. Our first designer is Luba Bakovich, and her fashions are worn by Helena Patrak from Kitchener-Waterloo, Carolyn Van Edig from Ottawa Valley, Brenda Gorlick from Manitoba, Julie McLeod from Mississauga, Joanne Chasen from Red Deer, Colleen Furlong from St. John, Sylvie Lavallee from Laval, Jacqueline McLean from Saskatoon, and Nora Jennings from Sault Ste. Marie. Luba's philosophy is that the modern woman of today needs fashion that will work for her, fashion that is feminine, but also practical. Simplicity in design is what she strives for, dresses, in jumpsuits, in tunics, and skirts. But it's a simplicity that is timeless and elegant. A simplicity that says, I am modern woman. For daytime, she believes strongly in the dress. Contemporary, clean, and never fussy. For evening, her designs have a touch of fantasy that will brighten up the night. Fashion today should reflect an attitude, a feeling, a lifestyle. Her clothes for prêt-à-porter do just that for the modern Canadian woman. Ladies and gentlemen, the fashions of Luba Bakovich. And now may I present the creations of Mimi Bendahan. The modeling Ms. Bendahan's fashions are Elizabeth Evans from Niagara Falls, Corrine Turner from Oakville, Krista Lee Goulding from Newfoundland Labrador, France Trudel from Trois-Rivières, Neva Peruzzolo from Vancouver, Renata Kratz from Regina, Simone Pereira from Brampton, Lauren Williams from Calgary, Kelly Murat from Yellowknife, Linda Marie Lank from Prince Edward Island. Mimi feels that after years of experience, she's come to the conclusion that fashion should be an individual thing. Wear what looks best on you and what makes you feel most comfortable. The same thing goes with colors. Keep in mind, you are a woman. All women are beautiful. Accent your best features and remain feminine. Even the most severe look can be softened with the variety of the accessories the market is full of. The key point is to be your own designer with what is offered to you. Reflecting the lifestyle of today, she tried her utmost to design a practical and wearable dress for most women with a touch of elegance and flair. It is her purpose to make a woman feel beautiful, feminine, and happy in what she wears. Ladies and gentlemen, the Mimi Bendahan collection for Pierre de Roche. Next, we have the fashions of Paula Leishman. Wearing Ms. Leishman's collection will be Kiki Christian from Prince George, Linda Frechette from Fort Frances, Madeline Kelly from Fort McMurray, Linda Lilago from South Shore, Julie Simp from Fort St. John, Cynthia Francis from Nova Scotia, Debbie Wilt from Bathurst, and Yvonne Robinson from Toronto. Paula Leishman is a young Canadian housewife and mother with an extensive textile arts background who felt the harsh chills of our Canadian winters and believed there was a better way to wear fur. Realizing that for years the Eskimos have worn fur on the inside for warmth and the newer Canadians were wearing it on the outside for durability and fashion, she felt there must be a technique to gain fur on both sides. So, working by the fireside in the evenings, she invented a method of knitting fur and evolved a new stretchable fabric with the desired fur on both sides, offering lightness, warmth, and natural ventilation. This breakthrough of a practical fur fabric, for which she now holds the Canadian patent, has led her into many avenues of fashion designs. This collection of designs, which are practical, versatile, and some just plain fun, truly reflect our Canadian heritage. Ladies and gentlemen, the fashions of Paula Leishman. And to complete our designer collection, the creations of Bernard McGee and Shelley Wickabrod, worn by Joanne Prue from Montreal, Renee McLaughlin from Hamilton, Lori Meindiger from Interior of British Columbia, Terry Harmon from Prince Albert, Rosalie Wald from Grand Prairie, Gail Craig from Burnaby, Cindy Benson from Edmonton, Irene Slabakowski from Windsor, and Karen Baldwin from London. Bernard McGee and Shelley Wickabrod of Clotheslines Incorporated feel contemporary classicism in tones of ivory is the elegant message for spring, summer, 1982. The suit collection, featuring structured jackets with a unique variety of trousers. Always full, the trousers vary in length, from the yoked ankle, to a cuff, to above the ankle, to the rouleau knee-length version. Coats are classic. The full pleated trench coat. The soft shawl-collared cashmere wrap. And the always elegant wrapped reefer with peaked lapels. Dresses promote a feeling of luxury, achieved in an elaborate expanse of fabric used. All have an attitude of priority. Ivory, an all-year fashion color. Ladies and gentlemen, the creations of Bernard McGee and Shelley Wickabrod.
And there you have our 35th anniversary Miss Canada Pageant Designer Collection. All the footwear shown with the designer collection was coordinated and supplied by Aggies of Agnew Surpass. And many thanks to the Scarborough Civic Center for their cooperation. And now please join me in congratulating our 36 representatives and the creators of that fabulous design collection. Luba Bakovich. Mimi Bendahan. Paula Leishman. Vernon McGee and Shelley Wickabrod. And to these gentlemen who originated those very exotic hair creations, Giancarlo and Massimo de Benedinis. Gentlemen, once again the 35th anniversary Miss Canada 1982 Designer Collection.
Hello, I'm Betty Jean Eastwood, and I was fortunate to be chosen Miss Canada in 1948. I can remember being away from my hometown of Halifax and being totally overwhelmed by all the activity. And I'm sure that most of our contestants feel the same way right now. We will return shortly to the 35th anniversary of the Miss Canada pageant, 1982.
Anything she wants.
Do you have a particular watch in mind?
Japanese.
Swiss.
To expect.
Ah, Swiss. The Bulova Swiss collection.
Gorgeous.
With quartz, the most accurate movement money can buy. And the price starts from $165.
Like I said, anything she wants.
Bulova, the Swiss watch without the Swiss price. The Bulova Swiss collection at better jewelers and fine department stores.
It's the high fashion shows that get really hectic. You never know what you'll be wearing next. Of course, it helps if you start with pantyhose from the Cameo collection. Cameo matches everything. Soft and silky, luxury that fits like a second skin.
The Cameo collection. It's where fashion begins.
And the cold is in your head, and your nose is sore and red. Scotty's, soften the blow.
Hi, I'm Scotty's little softy, here to remind you of the softness of Scotty's. Softness you can feel in your fingers. Softness you can feel on your nose.
Scotty's, soften the blow.
Get your very own cuddly doll of me, little softy. Details on Scotty's packages.
Bad news.
Oh, no.
Dad has to work late today.
Yeah, bye.
We feel so bad.
Well, Dad won't be home for dinner again.
Poor Dad. But there still is one way we can eat with our dad. You deserve a break today. You deserve a break today at McDonald's.
What makes a woman interesting is that inside, she's many women. To know her is to never stop discovering her. It is what makes all women beautiful. I feel the same about perfume. If it is exquisitely made, you never stop discovering it. It is constantly exciting to wear.
Like the woman who inspired it, Sophia by Coty. Always magnificent, never the same.
If it always seems like you get lots of what you don't like,
found some more.
Just have one more little job for you.
You'll be delighted to know that O. Henry gives you lots of what you do like. O. Henry's bigger than most other bars, so you get lots of rich fudge, lots of creamy caramel, lots of crunchy peanuts, all in a yummy chocolatey coating. The Big O. Henry. Lots for your money, lots for your tummy.
We will soon find out the identity of the first four semifinalists, but before we do, let's briefly continue our parade of fashions with the girls beside the pool at our host hotel, the Skyline Toronto.
We are poolside at our host hotel, where the girls spent a leisurely afternoon by the pool. Unfortunately, a very nervous bellboy couldn't say the same. With 36 girls to attend to, he was kept very busy all afternoon, supplying soft drinks, arranging the luggage, and whatever the girls needed. Bellboy again, looking a little weary and a little hassled, but he did his duties like a real trooper. Eventually, it was just too much for him, and he must have taken a wrong turn, because guess where he ended up? Later that day, the girls appeared in the Miss Canada swimsuit competition, and the winner received from Sea Queen a swimwear and cruisewear wardrobe designed by Laurie Brooks. The judges selected five finalists: Miss Toronto, Yvonne Robinson; Miss London, Karen Baldwin; Miss Mississauga, Julie McLeod; Miss Montreal, Joanne Prue; Miss Kitchener-Waterloo, Alana Patrak. And the winner was Yvonne Robinson from Toronto. Did you ever see anyone so excited and happy? And believe me, she was a most deserving winner. Miss Swimsuit 1982, Yvonne Robinson from Toronto. Yvonne has a degree in interior design. After gaining enough practical experience, she intends to have her own interior design company. What a delightful winner. And by the way, all 36 of our representatives will receive many elegant and beautiful gifts following the pageant. And here are but a few from the selection of our Regal Awards.
Miss Canada will wing her way to Britain with British Airways, the airline that knows Britain best and proves it each year to thousands of Canadians. 1982 pageant participants will travel first class all the way with their new Samsonite luggage. For each beauty, White Shoulders and Most Precious, exquisite world-famous fragrances from Evian Perfumes. The utmost in luxury from Molly Claire's exclusive crystal collection. Glorious colors and styles from Molly Claire. For Miss Canada 1982 and all contestants, a selection of Bonnie Bell cosmetics. Contestants receive a beautifully fashioned Bulova Swiss watch. Miss Canada receives an exquisite diamond set Bulova. These are just some of the lovely gifts which comprise the Regal Awards. And now, back to Jim.
The countdown has begun for the crowning of Miss Canada 1982. From all of our 36 representatives, the judges will choose 8 semifinalists. But before we hear their most important decision, let's welcome once again all 36 contestants for this, our 35th anniversary, Miss Canada 1982. Now, when 36 girls from 36 parts of the country meet for the first time, you can be assured that lasting friendships will be made. They spend many hours together rehearsing, shopping, and sightseeing, and after a full week, they get to know each other pretty well. And with this in mind, our representatives are asked to vote among themselves for the girl who, because of her understanding, or sense of humor, or just plain friendliness, will become this year's Miss Friendship. And to present the Miss Friendship Award, permit me to introduce to you one sweetheart of a lady who has been with this pageant for 18 years, our head chaperone, Ethel Berry. You look gorgeous tonight, Ethel. And ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this most coveted award, picked by the girls themselves, Miss Friendship, Madeline Kelly from Fort McMurray. Friendship 1982, Madeline Kelly from Fort McMurray. Congratulations. All of our lovely young ladies have been judged in every aspect of competition on a preliminary basis. From the preliminaries and the judging thus far this evening, the judges have selected our 8 semifinalists. So may I have the envelope, please? I will ask each girl to step forward as her name is called. In random order, the first 4 of our 8 semifinalists are Debbie Wilt from Bathurst. From Kitchener-Waterloo, Alena Patrak. Semi-finalist number three is Yvonne Robinson from Toronto. And completing the list of the first four of our eight semi-finalists is Renee McLaughlin from Hamilton. Ladies and gentlemen, the first four of our eight semifinalists. Congratulations. Our judge's decision is based not only on beauty, but poise, personality, and intellect as well. And to assist them on the selection of a new Miss Canada, we have asked each girl, if she were chosen, to make a statement on any subject that is important to her. So with that in mind, let's meet our first four semifinalists individually. And we'll begin with Debbie Wilt from Bathurst. Congratulations.
Thank you.
And if you will.
Good evening, bonsoir. J'ai choisi de vous entretenir ce soir d'un sujet qui nous préoccupe tous, qui que nous soyons. Si vous étiez au lit avec une fièvre de 40 degrés, ce donc, je veux vous parler, vous intéresser que la vie, la santé elle-même. Lorsqu'on essaie de comprendre l'être humain dans le plus profond de son essence, lorsqu'on tente de saisir ce qui le motive et le mue, on retrouve, à la source, le moteur même de la vie. Mes amis, il s'agit de la recherche du bonheur. My gift to every one of you is the wish for that today you all learn to be more positive. Thank you. Merci.
Debbie Wilt from Bathurst. Thank you, Debbie. Elena Patrak from Kitchener-Waterloo. Elena, the microphone is yours.
Thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I think that on the whole, Canadians tend to complain too much. I realize we have political and economical problems, but we must never forget that this still is a wonderful country to call our home, and I wish we could regain some of the patriotic pride that we have lost over the years. Thank you.
Good thinking from Elena Patrak from Kitchener-Waterloo. Thank you, Elena. Here's Yvonne Robinson from Toronto. And congratulations to you, Yvonne, if you will.
Good evening. Being confident is of great importance to me. Confident enough to know that what I'm doing is the best I can do. Sometime in the future, when I look back, I want to know that I'm not going to have any regrets for the choices I've made. So no matter what you do or what you choose to say, give it all you've got and be confident. And maybe when you look back, you won't have any regrets either. Thank you.
Yvonne Robinson from Toronto. Thank you, Yvonne. Here is Renee McLaughlin from Hamilton.
Hello. Those that try to discover their talents or special interests in certain fields should also try to develop them. Once they do, not only will they feel confident about themselves, but they will surely be a benefit to society. Souvenez-vous que la ressource plus importante d'un pays, ce sont les gens. Tout le reste est secondaire. Remember, a country's best resource is its people. All else is secondary. Thank you.
Renee McLaughlin from Hamilton. Thank you, Renee. I think they did beautifully. Ladies and gentlemen, our congratulations to the first four of our eight semifinalists.
Hello, I'm Marilyn Reddick, and I was chosen Miss Canada in 1952. And I remember at this point in the pageant when I was chosen as semi-finalist, I was ecstatic, as I'm sure our first four semi-finalists are right now. And we will be back shortly to announce four more semi-finalists on this, the 35th anniversary Miss Canada pageant 1982.
I know the name, and I love the way you've changed. I can taste it now, must be new town now. It came pouring in on me, the cooler taste it said to me. It's new town now, I can taste it now. Just a single calorie, positively sugar-free. Bigger, richer taste,
Faces within faces. Light changing, reflecting, scintillating. That's the infinite beauty of diamonds from Birks. Birks Diamonds, a beautiful reflection on you.
Chimere, an extraordinary fragrance by Prince Machiavelli. Like you, it has a public side and a private side. Chimere tells the world one thing, but up close, it says a little more. Chimere, to the world, it's discreet, elegant, but up close, it's something else. Chimere.
Hey, Victoria Principal, what's the secret of your beautiful hair?
Germac, my hairdresser told me about it. He calls it his trade secret of beautiful hair. Frankly, it's terrific. Each Germac shampoo and conditioner is professionally formulated for different hair needs. My hair was dry and unmanageable. Today, body, bounce, shine. Never looked healthier. Germac, that's my secret. Try Germac, trade secret of beautiful hair.
You can feel the cottony softness, the softness of cottonelle.
Cottonelle. Cottony soft, that's what cottonelle is. Cottony soft, just as the name suggests.
Especially with her, I have to think of her also. I find that it's very soft.
It's fluffy. If you pick up the roll, you can feel how soft it is.
Cottony softness from Scott's cottonelle.
All of our 36 girls performed for the first time for our judges in front of an audience last Friday night at our host hotel, the Skyline Toronto. And if you're wondering about opening night jitters, well, you're absolutely right. Present in the audience that night were many distinguished guests from the business and entertainment community, which made it a very exciting evening for all our contestants, and a very exciting evening for my co-host, Dave Duvall, and myself. This was their first opportunity to model their smashing evening gowns. The gowns worn by myself and the girls were designed especially for the Miss Canada pageant by the outstanding Canadian designer Wayne Clark, manufactured by Aileen Morel Limited in Toronto. I must say they looked so very stunning, wouldn't you say? And all our regional representatives will receive a selection of gifts. Here are several more examples of our Miss Canada Regal Awards.
From one champion to another, a delicious assortment of soft drinks from Coca-Cola Limited. Penman's proudly presents activewear to each contestant and is especially pleased to award the newly crowned Miss Canada with an entire activewear sports wardrobe because Penman's is made for action. All representatives and Miss Canada 1982 receive footwear from Aggies of Agnew Surpass as seen throughout the telecast. Aggies, the official footwear of the Miss Canada pageant. Tonight's contestants and hostesses are wearing beautiful jewelry from Sarah Coventry. Miss Canada will also receive a complete jewelry wardrobe from the new Sarah Coventry, famous for fine fashion jewelry. Yamaha Canada Music presents a Yamaha Grand Piano to Miss Canada. Beautiful music for the beautiful Miss Canada. Miss Canada 1982 and representatives will receive other fine gifts which make up the Regal Awards. And now, let's return to the pageant and Barbara Kelly.
And on this, our anniversary, we're reflecting the events that have occurred over this globe during the past 35 years. Some that have created great sorrow, and some that have given us great pleasure. And we thought that you would like to share some of the more memorable happenings with us. And at the top of our list was the source of the greatest musical comedy entertainment in the world, The Great White Way. Broadway. So please welcome Jim Perry, Brian Mackay, Judy Marshak, and our reigning Miss Canada, Dominique Dufour, with our 36 lovely ladies presenting 35 Years of Broadway.
Mm-hmm.
listen to the lullaby of Broadway, the hip hooray and ballyhoo, until the dawn. Good night, baby. Good night. Let's call it a day. Listen to the lullaby of old Broadway.
Roving and wondering life I had on any lass I found who would try to tie me down. But then one day I saw a maid who held out her hand and I stayed and stayed. And now across the green I'll go home with Bonnie Jean.
Once in love with A, always in love with A.
Nothing like a dame.
Nothing in the world.
There is nothing you can name that is anything like a dame.
I love Paris in the springtime. I love Paris in the fall.
It's never too late to have a fling,
for autumn is just as nice as spring.
And it's never too late to fall in love.
Boop-a-doo,
boop-a-doo,
boop-a-doo. It's never too late to wink an eye.
I'll do it until the day I die. And it's never too late to fall in love.
Whack-a-doo,
whack-a-doo, whack-a-doo.
You gotta have heart, 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 heart.
Oh, I'm getting married in the morning. Ding dong, the bells are gonna chime. Pull out the stopper, let's have a whopper, but get me to the church on time.
Tonight won't be just any night. Tonight there will be no morning star.
What kind of fire will never fail in love? It seems that I'm the only one that I have been thinking of. What kind of man is this? An empty shell, a lonely cell in which an empty heart must dwell. Is this the little girl I carry? Is this the little girl at play? I don't remember growing older. When did they?
Sunrise, sunset, sunrise, sunset, swiftly.
The minute you walked in the joint, I could see you were a man of distinction, a real big spender, good looking, so refined. Say, wouldn't you like to know what's going on in my mind? So let me get right to the point. I don't pop my cork for every guy I see. Hey, big spender, spend a little time with me.
What good is sitting alone in your room? Come hear the music play. Life is a cabaret, old Jean. Come to the cabaret.
Little old New York, you'll find a thoroughfare. It's the part of little old New York that runs into Times Square.
A crazy quilt that Wall Street Jack built. If you got a little time to spare, I wanna take you there.
Come and meet those dancing feet on the avenue I'm taking you to, 42nd Street. Hear the beat of dancing feet. It's the song I
Miss Canada Pageant 1982 will return.
Introducing a new conditioner that goes only where your hair needs it. Silkians. It's new. Scientific scanner photography shows you. The light colors show how Silkians goes only where Brenda's hair needs it. But Sue needs more conditioning. All over. And Chisa needs it only on the ends. Silkians. What you don't need rinses clean away. Silkians. The science of silkening your hair.
And that's not greasy kid stuff.
To a baseball player, nothing feels as good as the home run. Leaving towns like Philly, St. Louis, and Pittsburgh. Coming home to your own bed and the softness of Tex-Made sheets. The softness and style of TexMate, Canada's number one sheets. It's enough to make baseball's number one catcher feel right at home.
Wake up, Gary.
Home, sweet home.
There are some things you talk about, and some you don't. At Scott Paper, we make products known for softness, and some we talk about on television. We also make new Confidence Maxi Pads. And for them, we'd prefer you read our ads in these popular magazines, because new Confidence Maxi Pads are made for comfort. And that's something you'd rather read about than talk about. You understand.
Hey, babe, what'll it be? You can do just what you please. Through your day or through your town, you move through life with perfect ease.
Babe from Fabergé, for that fresh scent of perfect freedom.
A lot of people in Canada are confused about whether or not this country's running out of oil. Well, they've got good reason to be confused, because the answer is yes and no. Yes, we are running out of this kind of oil, oil that's relatively easy and inexpensive to get out of the ground. But we do have other kinds of oil in the oil sands, in the Arctic, and beneath the ocean floor. Enough oil to last us for several hundred years. That other kind of oil, however, is difficult to get at and expensive to get out. Right now, Canada's facing decisions that will determine when and how much of that other kind of oil will be available for use. At the Canadian Petroleum Association, we think better decisions can be made when everybody understands the facts. So we're doing our best to help you understand more about the oil and gas aspects of energy, because we believe energy solutions begin with understanding.
Grace, the poise, and the style as well. Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this year's Yamaha Talent Award, Miss Hamilton Renee McLaughlin.
Thank you. While I was living in South America, I fell in love with South American music. This is one of my favorite pieces.
Bailen la bamba,
Hamilton, a delightful and deserving winner. Now, speaking of talent, I'd like you to know that our chaperones are a group of dedicated individuals who vote their time to the pageant in order to ensure that all our 36 girls have an enjoyable stay in a city that could be a little strange for them. The chaperones work long hours, and from my personal experience, I can tell you that they're always friendly and always have a smile on their face. And for a girl who has just left a city or town for the first time, that, believe me, is a very welcome sight. This year, there was an added bonus from our chaperones. They decided to have a little fun amongst themselves, which came as a bit of a surprise to everyone.
Looks like a very good time was had by all. I mean a good time. Weren't they something? You've met our first four semifinalists. Now the time has come for the announcement of our last four semifinalists. So, judges. I have the names of the remaining four semi-finalists right here. Karen Baldwin from London. Semi-finalist number six is from Fort St. John, Julie Semft. From Montreal, Joanne Prue. And completing the list of the eight semifinalists is Brenda Gorlick from Manitoba. And there they are, ladies and gentlemen, our last four semifinalists. Congratulations. And now, as we did with our first four semifinalists, let's meet each young lady individually, speaking on any subject that she feels is important to her. So here is Karen Baldwin from London. Congratulations, if you will.
Thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I feel it is important for an individual to have goals in this life. I feel that life is beautiful and time is precious, and we shouldn't be doing things that we feel are a waste of time or we aren't enjoying doing. In order to obtain these goals, you have to realize your potentials. And I feel that the greatest ambition or the greatest goal in life is to be happy. Thank you.
Karen Baldwin. Thank you, Karen. Here is Julie Semp from Fort St. John. Julie, congratulations, if you will.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I feel that today the word love is used in such a casual way. It's just a casual comment that is sort of passed on. Love is not an emotion that comes and goes, it's a commitment. The words can never say what the actions can prove. I think it's time we learn to love unconditionally. Thank you.
Julie Semp from Fort St. John. Thank you, Julie. Here is Joanne Prue from Montreal.
Good evening, bonsoir. Le sujet que j'ai choisi de vous parler, c'est un langage que tout le monde peut comprendre. Que l'on parle français, anglais ou une autre langue, le son est le même à l'oreille. Bien sûr, vous avez deviné, c'est la musique. Dans chacune de nos vies, la musique marque des moments bien précis. Combien de fois dans une discothèque, on s'amuse, on rit, on danse. Puis tout d'un coup, la musique se fait plus douce. On joint nos places et en regardant les couples qui dansent, nous voilà partis dans des souvenirs bien lointains. Un amour qui n'est pas encore cicatrisé. Et la voilà bien cruelle, cette musique. Cela m'impressionne beaucoup. Je ne sais pas d'où elle vient ni jusqu'où elle ira. Mais je sais une chose, c'est qu'elle vit avec nous. C'est ça qui est important. Merci beaucoup.
Joanne Plouffe from Montreal. Merci. Merci, Joanne. Here is Brenda Gorlick from Manitoba. And Brenda, if you will.
Good evening. As a performing artist, it is obvious to me that we have a high wealth of talent in the country, not only in dance, drama, and music, but within our cultural mosaic as well. We are fortunate to have access to multicultural population, which inevitably serves to enhance our Canadian identity, and I hope that this is never taken for granted. As was so aptly put in one of Lighthouse's recordings, understand together, stand together. Thank you very much.
Brenda Gorlick from Manitoba. Thank you, Brenda. And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen, our eight semi-finalists for the coveted crown, Miss Canada 1982.
And I was fortunate to be chosen Miss Canada 1968. I remember being away from my family in Summerside, Prince Edward Island for the first time in my life and then being chosen a semi-finalist. I was completely awestruck, as I know our eight semi-finalists are right now. We will return to all the excitement on this, the 35th anniversary of the Miss Canada pageant 1982.
I'm about to do something Canadians do 7 million times a day. That's right. You enjoy the real thing, refreshing ice-cold Coca-Cola, an average of 7 million times a day. That's more than all other regular colas combined. Yeah, including this one. So that means 7 million smiles a day. 49 million smiles a week, 2,555,000,000 smiles a year. Yes, indeed. And there goes another one. I saw you smile because you didn't think I could count that high.
Sellers asks, do you have to pay top dollar to get top quality? You be the judge. This week, the Sunbeam Big Pop 4-quart hot air corn popper with built-in butter melting tray, or the Oster Galaxy 10-speed blender with 5-cup container, $34.97 each, and the Sunbeam 12-speed mixer with stand, $74.97. So if you've heard the theory that you have to pay a lot to get a lot, discount it. We have. Shop Zellers this Christmas. Only you'll know how little you paid.
Jim Abel, what do you wear when you want to feel like a million bucks?
My favorite tweed jacket and my millionaire for a minute.
Ned Parker, what do you wear when you want to feel like a million bucks?
My lucky hat and my millionaire for a minute.
Introducing Menin Millionaire, the gold standard of men's colognes. So rich, so masculine, you feel like a million bucks. Paul Marini, what do you wear it with?
You have to ask.
Menin Millionaire, whatever you wear it with, you feel like a million bucks.
When the cold is in your head and your nose is sore and red, Scotties, soften the blow.
Hi, I'm Scotty's little softie, here to remind you of the softness of Scotties. Softness you can feel in your fingers. Softness you can feel on your nose.
Scotties, soften the blow.
Get your very own cuddly doll of me, little softie. Details on Scotty's packages.
I retired early from hockey because it was interfering with my golf game, but I brought along a friend from the dressing room, Deep Heating Rub. With muscular aches and pains, exercise or too many body checks leave you a little stiff and sore, rub in the Deep Heating. It sends heat soaking in and helps get those muscles moving again. I use Deep Heating because it helps keep me moving. Okay, guys, ready to lose a little money?
Happy birthday!
Oh, my goodness!
Me
everybody. Here comes your present. There you are. Happy birthday.
Big spender.
Oh, just sweet bell.
Good-looking pig. I've seen better.
With a one-step, you can see your pictures before the candles go out.
Cake looks great.
Yeah, but don't cut it.
What?
It's rented.
Rented? Well, rent yourself another pig. And give me my picture.
Polaroid means fun.
With a one-step.
Well, now we have chosen our eight semifinalists, one of whom will become Miss Canada 1982. And I'm glad I'm not casting a ballot, for as usual, it becomes a most difficult choice. And to help you along with your personal decision, and of course, the decision of our distinguished panel of judges, here once again are our eight semifinalists in the Miss Canada swimsuit competition. This is Debbie Wilt from Bathurst.
Debbie, a 19-year-old service representative, is 5 feet 6 inches tall, with brown hair and brown eyes. She recently completed a modeling course and enjoys many sports, including softball and cross-country skiing.
Kitchener-Waterloo, Elena Petrak.
Alana is a 21-year-old student with green eyes and brown hair. She is 5 feet 7 inches tall, and leisure activities range from horseback riding to sketching to modern dance. She's lived in Czechoslovakia and has traveled in other parts of Europe.
From Toronto, Yvonne Robinson.
Yvonne is 5 feet 8 inches tall, with dark brown hair and brown eyes. She's 23 years old. Born in Toronto, she speaks fluent Spanish and has traveled through North America and Mexico.
From Hamilton, Renee McLaughlin.
5 foot 7 inch tall brunette with green eyes, Renee is 20 years old and a part-time model. Fluent in Spanish, she includes guitar playing and horseback riding in her leisure activities.
From London, Karen Baldwin.
18-year-old Karen has chestnut hair and green eyes and is 5 feet 9 inches tall. A student and an avid sportswoman, water polo and cross-country running are two of the activities she enjoys most.
Fort St. John, Julie Simpt.
Julie is 21 years old with ash blonde hair and brown eyes. She's 5 feet 7 inches tall and works as a secretary bookkeeper. She's played with a concert and stage band as a clarinetist.
From Montreal, Joanne Prue.
With brown hair and brown eyes, 19-year-old Joanne is 5 feet 7 inches tall. Working in sales, she's a keen amateur singer who also enjoys dancing, drawing, and reading.
And from Manitoba, Brenda Gorlick.
23-year-old Brenda has brown hair and brown eyes and is 5 feet 5 inches tall. A dancer, singer, and actress herself, she still loves to be part of an audience in theater and at the movies.
Ladies and gentlemen, our eight semifinalists in the swimsuit competition. Thank you, girls.
The swimsuit the girls are wearing is the official Miss Canada swimsuit. It was designed by Lori Brooks of Sea Queen.
In just a short while, we'll be crowning a new Miss Canada, and tomorrow she'll begin a year of travel, which will take her throughout Canada and the world. Our reigning Miss Canada, Dominique Dufour's role as our country's representative and goodwill ambassador was very rewarding, yet very demanding. But all in all, she says she wouldn't have traded it for the world. Here are her thoughts on her year of travel.
After becoming Miss Canada 1981, I returned to Laval for a wonderful homecoming with my friends and family. And I also met the mayor of Laval, the very nice Dr. Lucien Paiement. And then it was off to a five-day visit in the Bahamas, where I stayed at the beautiful Shalimar Hotel, which is part of the York Hanover chain. Then I had a wonderful time sightseeing and shopping with Miss Teen Canada, Heather Hiscox. What a lovely girl. And then we went on a fabulous cruise around the islands. It was just beautiful. Following that, we had the largest barbecue I've ever seen. The food was so good. Upon my return to Canada, I participated in the annual Niagara Blossom Festival and met so many nice people. Then it was off to London, England, courtesy of British Airways and Holiday Inn. I had a great week sightseeing in Trafalgar Square, the famous Tower of London, and even Westminster Abbey. I had a fabulous time shopping and especially visiting the well-known Madame Tussauds Wax Museum. Shortly after, I went on an exciting two-week Caribbean cruise in the Virgin Islands, which is something I will never forget. A few weeks later, I was very fortunate to be in the wonderful Orange Bowl Parade in Florida on New Year's Eve. Everyone there enjoyed themselves so very much. When I returned to Canada, I visited the city of Moncton, New Brunswick, and met so many friendly people at the Moncton Boat and Trailer Show. And then to the most exciting time of my life, flying to New York for the Miss Universe pageant, where I became the first runner-up. This is something I will never forget for the rest of my life.
Here are the names of this year's semi-finalists, one of whom will be the new Miss Universe. And this last spot among the 12 semi-finalists is for Miss Canada. Number five on the list of five. She is Miss Canada. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I shall read the name of the first runner-up and then Miss Universe. The first runner-up is Miss Canada.
I think one could safely say there couldn't have been a better choice than Dominique Dufour representing our country during her reign. Now the judges are just about ready with a decision on who will be our four finalists for the very special role of Miss Canada 1982. And as they're making that decision, I'd like to present some of the beautiful and elegant gifts our future Miss Canada will receive from our superb collection on the Regal Awards.
From Henry Birx, a beautiful ring with 33 Birx diamonds set in 14 karat gold. From Royal Worcester, leaders in oven-to-tableware fashion, a selection of china, crystal, and silverware. For Miss Canada and each contestant, a selection of Tex-Made and Caldwell products from Dominion Textile. For Miss Canada 1982, a fur fashion of her personal choice. All Regal Award fashions have been modeled tonight by the reigning Miss Canada, Dominique Dufour. Our new Miss Canada will be traveling in comfort, economy, and head-turning style in her brand-new 1982 front-wheel drive Chevy Citation. A very special traveling companion for a very special young lady on the move. Chevy makes good things happen. The Regal Awards Miss Canada and representatives receive will enhance their memories of the pageant. And now back to Jim for the exciting climax of the Miss Canada pageant 1982.
We are now very close to that very exciting moment. The decision of our judges on our four finalists, and I'm sure you can understand, as the number of girls remaining becomes smaller, the decision-making becomes increasingly more difficult. I've been informed that the judges are ready with their decision. So, judges. Ladies and gentlemen, in random order, the four finalists are... From London, Karen Baldwin! The second finalist is... Yvonne Robinson from Toronto! From Montreal, Joanne Prue. And the fourth finalist for the Miss Canada crown is Renee McLaughlin from Hamilton. Ladies and gentlemen, our four finalists for the title Miss Canada 1982.
I'm Yvonne Foster, and I was Miss Canada 1977. I remember how surprised and thrilled I was when I was chosen one of the four finalists, wondering who was going to be the next Miss Canada, as I'm sure our four finalists are wondering right now. So we will return with the announcement of the winner on this, the 35th anniversary Miss Canada pageant 1982.
There are some things you talk about, and some you don't. At Scott Paper, we make products known for softness, and some we talk about on television. We also make new Confidence Maxi Pads, and for them, we prefer you read our ads in these popular magazines, because new Confidence Maxi Pads are made for comfort, and that's something you'd rather read about than talk about. You understand.
If you're willing to work a little, you can have fresher looking skin with this, a pre-apricot facial scrub. But be ready, it's different. You just add water and rub into a lather. You can actually feel it working, getting rid of that dead skin layer that can clog your pores and cause skin problems. Your face looks fresh, glowing, alive. A pre-apricot facial scrub. Isn't your skin worth it?
I am made of blue sky and golden light, and I will feel this way forever.
Share the fantasy. Chanel number 5.
I know the name, and I love the way you've changed. I can taste it now, must be new town now. It came pouring in on me, the cooler taste, it said to me. It's new town now, I can taste it now. Just a single calorie, positively sugar-free. Bigger, richer taste, so much better than.
Hey, Victoria Principal, what's the secret of your beautiful hair?
Germack, my hairdresser told me about it. He calls it his trade secret of beautiful hair. Frankly, it's terrific. Each Germack shampoo and conditioner is professionally formulated for different hair needs. My hair was dry and unmanageable. Today, body, bounce, shine. Never looked healthier. Germack, that's my secret. Try Germack, trade secret of beautiful hair.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this point, I'd like to take a brief moment to mention the Miss Canada Scholarship, which is designed to assist deserving candidates in furthering their education and training. This is one aspect of the pageant which we, and I'm sure each of the girls, feels is very important to them. And now to the final phase of competition. With it, the judges will get one last opportunity to observe the composure of each of our finalists under the pressure she must face if she becomes Miss Canada. I will now ask each girl a question. Now, these questions have been prepared from information supplied by the girls themselves and approved by the chairperson of the judges, Patricia Guire. So we'll begin with Karen Baldwin from London. Karen? Karen, the question prepared for you reads, since you have had special training in jazz and ballet dancing, name your favorite ballet and briefly comment on its theme.
My favorite ballet is Swan Lake. I feel that way because it expressed so much emotion into the play. Thank you.
Thank you, Karen. Karen Baldwin, thank you. Our second finalist, Yvonne Robinson from Toronto. Yvonne? Yes, indeed. You don't mind a little encouragement, eh? Your question is, tell us who is your favorite classical guitarist and comment on a particular rendition of his or her music.
I have to say that my favorite guitarist is Mason Williams, and my favorite piece of his is Classical Gas. I get a lot of emotion, a lot of feeling from it, and even though it's been out for several years now, every time I hear it, I still love it just as much, if not more. Thank you.
Yvonne Robinson from Toronto. Thank you, Yvonne. Here is Joanne Prue from Montreal. And Joanne, I know you prefer to answer in French, so we will call on our translator, Roland Kerouac, if you will. Roland? And Joanne? And Roland? Your question is, give two reasons why, in your opinion, the judges gave you an award in a recent singing contest. Two reasons.
Pourriez-vous donner deux raisons pourquoi les juges vous ont donné un prix dans un concours récent de chant?
Eh bien, je crois d'abord parce que pour moi, c'est très important. C'est ma vie, chanter. Et puis, je pense que je mets beaucoup le feeling quand je chante, vraiment. Et puis, je pense que les gens l'ont ressenti. C'est que moi, vraiment, c'est moi chanter. Alors, je pense que ce serait pour ça. Merci.
Miss Montreal has said that singing is her life, and she would like to make a career of it. And it is, singing is so important to her, she felt that the judges really felt it. And that's why they gave her the prize.
Thank you, Joanna. Thank you, Roland. Joanne Prue from Montreal. And from Hamilton, Renee McLaughlin. Renee, how do you feel that living in South America has broadened your view of life?
I have lived in South America for 12 years, and one thing that I have learned is the emotion of happiness. The South American people are always peppy, no matter what the situation, and they have political and economical problems, more so than Canada, yet somehow they seem to muddle through. Thank you.
Renee McLaughlin from Hamilton. Thank you, Renee. And thank you all. I think they did beautifully. And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen, our four finalists for the title Miss Canada 1982.
The judges are now in the final process of selecting our new Miss Canada. And from personal experience, I know the tension and excitement those girls are feeling right now. It is a feeling that will probably never be duplicated again in their lifetime. And the one young lady who experienced this a few little files ago tonight is about to relinquish her crown. Miss Canada 1981, a good friend, Dominique Dufour.
Traveling and expanding my knowledge of our beautiful country, placing as first runner-up in the Miss Universe pageant, and meeting many delightful people have been highlights in my year as Miss Canada. While working in another language than French has increased my opportunities to exchange ideas with others. Sometimes the fun was suppressed by the work, but learning to be adaptable, I believe, is an ability I will need in the career I hope to pursue in acting and broadcasting. For all of this, I would like to sincerely thank the people at Clio Productions, the sponsors, and everyone who helped me through this wonderful year. J'aimerais aussi remercier tous mes amis et surtout ma famille pour m'avoir si bien encouragé au cours de cette année. Papa, maman, Claudine, Anne, Elisabeth, Benoît, vous êtes merveilleux, je vous aime. Merci. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the last time, a great Miss Canada 1981, Dominique Dufour. And now, our panel of judges have made their final decision. Our auditor has tabulated the results, and the moment everyone has been waiting for is here. May I have the envelope, please? I have the names of the new Miss Canada and the three runners-up. I will announce the names of our winners, beginning with the third runner-up. The third runner-up is Joanne Prue from Montreal. The second runner-up for the Miss Canada crown, from Toronto, Yvonne Robinson. The next name will be the first runner-up, the second most important award tonight. If for any reason Miss Canada cannot complete her reign, the first runner-up will assume the title. The first runner-up is Renee McLaughlin, Miss Canada 1982, Karen Baldwin from London. Miss Canada 1982 from London, Ontario, Karen Baldwin. And a beautiful Miss Canada she is. On behalf of Barbara Kelly, Brian McKay, Judy Marshak, our wonderful former Miss Canadas, and Dominique Dufour, good night from the 35th anniversary Miss Canada pageant 1982. Good night, everyone.
Miss Canada pageant has been brought to you in part by Scott Paper's family of fine products and by your bottler of Coca-Cola, the champion of soft drinks.
This is the CTV Television Network.